This is a new sound synthesis technique, and it can look at objects in a scene without a sound, and after that, create these sounds.
Duke, I am your father.
Wow! And now, first, here is a real-life situation. Okay, and now a simulation. Wait a minute, nothing is coming. Why? Well, because this was the computer simulation. When I first saw and heard it, I couldn't believe it. It looks and sounds so real. I refuse to believe that this was made by a computer digitally. Yes, all the sounds here are synthesized by this technique. And get this, no AI was used whatsoever. All human ingenuity. That is unbelievable. So, how is that even possible? Well, what it does is that it looks at objects and breaks them down into little Lego pieces. Let's call them voxels. And then it simulates pressure waves sloshing around to create all this sound. Imagine the scene turned into two voxel modes, one for the start and one for the end. And the method smoothly morphs the air between them while pressure waves bounce around. Each cell has a tiny little slider saying, I'm air or I'm solid. So when the objects move or deform, the sound updates smoothly instead of cutting or popping. It's like a DJ blending one song into the next one so you don't even notice the change. Unbelievable work! And this means that it does not just play sounds. It understands the space they happen in. A splash near a wall sounds different than one in an open field, and this solver makes that difference come alive automatically. Just think about how many game developers and film studios will want this. No more hours of hand-placing sound effects. No, the physics just does the work for you. But wait a second, so that means that it can take this geometry into consideration. If it didn't, these little M&Ms would sound like this. But it is now closed between the hands, so with this new technique, it sounds like this. Yes, we still hear it, but it's a bit muffled, as physics would say. Incredible result! And when you dig into the paper for details, the achievements become even more impressive. If that is even possible. So here are 10 things I didn't expect at all. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Carol. 1. All this works with pre-recorded sounds, vibrating shells, sloshing liquids, even Lego bricks, all inside one unified solver. You don't need a bunch of different algorithms for different kinds of interactions. This alone can do almost everything. Absolutely insane. 2. It runs on uniform grids only, which could also be thought of as a limitation, but it actually makes it super GPU friendly and keeps everything simple and fast. And yes, now hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because thus they run everything on a single GPU and it easily beats a high-end multi-core CPU. Typical speedups are at around 140x faster, reaching up to 1000x faster than the old solver in some cases. From just one paper to the next one, we are jumping 1000x. I can't believe it. 3. Even at low resolution, some demos, like the Cup Phone, already run faster than real time. Yes! Finally! We are on the doorstep of interactive sound simulations. 4. It smoothly interpolates between animation frames, avoiding the popping artifacts that plagued earlier methods, like fading one movie scene into another. No hard cuts. It works really well. 5. It can handle crazy geometry changes, like cavities opening and closing without exploding numerically. 6, it even simulates more than 300,000 of these candy impact sounds, which is incredible. Though not real time yet, it just needs about 15 seconds of waiting for 1 second of sound. 7, it solves the tricky problem where air appears after an object moves by filling in missing pressure and velocity fields with a global least square solution, keeping the simulation stable. Like a puzzle that magically spawns the missing piece the moment you notice the hole. 8. It supports tiny, point-like sound sources for things like debris or splashes, so you don't need ultra-fine grids to hear every little click. 9. It can even add phantom geometry, just math, not real objects. You can use these to shape the sound to your liking. That's sound design with superpowers. 10. For moving objects, it resets the boundary conditions smartly, so sounds don't suddenly pop when something enters a noisy area. This is a subtle detail, but it makes everything feel physically believable. And perhaps the most exciting part is that it is not far from real-time interactive sound synthesis. Imagine being in VR, picking up objects, smashing them together, and the sound you hear is computed on the fly by physics. This could change how every movie, game, and simulation sounds. No more canned audio, just pure physics-driven soundscapes. The future of sound is not recorded. It is computed, and it's going to be spectacular. Once again, no AI needed. Just think about how crazy that is. And once again, almost nobody is talking about this work. I don't think you would hear a word about this incredible paper anywhere else, only here. So, if you would subscribe, like, and leave a kind comment, I would be very grateful, and you would get to hear more about amazing works like this. Code is available, dataset is available, all free of charge. It is incredible! What a time to be alive! Fellow scholars, check this out. This is Deep Infra, an AI inference cloud where you can get access to the best open AI models like DeepSeek, Llama, and pay up to 10 times less than elsewhere. Or use my favorite, the amazing Flux text-to-image AI, generate speech from text, and more. It is super easy to use. Try it out today at deepinfra.com/papers or click the link in the description and you get $20 of credit for free.